And hello, everybody, and welcome to Shelby County Athletic League action. Mark Bixler being joined by Scott Ward tonight, and it is the Houston Wildcats hosting the Rushi Raiders in a key SCAL game. And Scott, whenever two teams hook up in the SCAL, throw out the record books. I don't care what takes place prior to that, it's going to be a good basketball game.
Exactly right. No matter what, in this whole league, whether a team's 0-10 coming into a game or 10-0, like you said, throw out the record books, and it's going to be, you know, a battle all the way to the end. It's just this is a good league that, you know, when you're looking for some good basketball, Shelby County League basketball is what you want to come watch if you want to see a great game down to the wire.
Well, it's a Friday night, and you'll see as we broadcast tonight's ball game, it's a pretty there's not too many empty seats tonight.
No, this is a packed house here at Houston. It's going to be a crazy loud place. We were here during the reserve game and just very ecstatic, and Rushi fans for years have brought crazy and loud fans, and it'll be a loud one here tonight in a small packed compact gym.
Well, you mentioned the JV score. Rushi taking the JV by a final of, I believe it was 60-35, if I'm not mistaken. So congratulations to the Raiders with that. Tonight, an interesting matchup. Rushi coming in undefeated, if I'm not mistaken. 10-1, one loss. But they are the state runner-up from a year ago, and that puts a big target on your back.
Oh, a big target, as you said, from state runner-up. Their one loss coming this year to the Fort Laramie Redskins, and that's where their one league loss is, too. So they have a big target. Houston is coming out. You know, they've got everything to go for, and Rushi's got to really come out and play a tough game because, as you said, with that big target on their back, you know, they've got to stand out there and play a great game tonight versus Houston.
You know, this is a Shelby County Athletic League, a very competitive league. For those in the Salina system and the Minster system who go to schools who attend the Midwest or are part of the Midwest Athletic Conference, I would say this, the SCAL is one of the top three teams, top three conferences in the state, at least in my estimation. The Midwest Athletic Conference being one, Shelby County Athletic League being another, and the third, the Putnam County League, with Kaleida, Miller City, Columbus Grove, Fort Jennings, Lipsick, Ottoville, down the list. All of those schools with a lot of tradition. But the man that gets a lot of the ink in the Putnam County League, Dick Quartercracks, now has over 700 wins. And that's a target a lot of coaches would like to get to.
Exactly. And Rushi's got a coach here in Paul Brigham. He's been here for many years, and he's doing an excellent job. He has done for many years with this Rushi Raiders team. And he's once again leading this team to 10-1 record right now. And these guys are looking to go at where they did last year and even extend past that and be state champs this year.
Now, I'm dating myself. I can remember when Paul was the JV coach, and that's been a long time ago.
Yeah, I can, as far as I remember, he's always been a varsity coach to me.
Well, it is the Rushi Raiders visiting the Houston Wildcats. Scott Ward and myself will be back with all of the action here from Houston in just a moment.
Helping bring you this event, the Made Right Sandwich Shop, located on North Broadway in Greenville by the Ansonia Lumber Company on Main Street in Ansonia, Gilbert Feller's Funeral Home located in Brookville, Greenville National Bank with several locations in Dark County, by Cox Insurance located in Ansonia and Greenville, by Homestretch Sportswear located in St. Henry and Wapakoneta, and by M. Bixler Video Productions. Helping bring you this event, by Oliver Floyd Funeral Home in Greenville, Montage Cafe on Broadway in Greenville, by McCain Painting Incorporated, located in Greenville, by Osgood State Bank, located in Osgood, Family Health Services in Greenville, Arcanum, Versailles, and New Madison, by State Farm Insurance, your agent, Jim Gable, and by M. Bixler Video Productions.
Thank you.
And a fine job by the Houston High School Pep Band. And as we said during the pregame, as you're looking on the Houston side, not a whole lot of empty seats here tonight.
No, not a whole lot. You see a few scattered here and there. And you look, if you take a look, even on the Rushi side, it's still a packed house over here on the near on our side. So it's going to be a packed house. It'll be a crazy one. Shelby County League basketball, as we mentioned earlier, is just wild and crazy, and it's great basketball to watch. And it gets very exciting and loud as each game goes on and we get closer toward tournament time.
And the Rushi fans definitely looking forward to that, especially after last year's run all the way to the state championship game before falling to a very good Delphi St. John's team. And for those in the Versailles system, Delphi St. John's coached by a young man with a lot of ties to Versailles, Brett Norris.
Yeah, Brett Norris, he's with the Blue Jays. He carried him, you know, to the state championship game last year and won it. And it was just, his team was well coached last year, and they were an excellent playing team. And it just proved it. Each game they got better and better, and as a result, won the state championship.
Delphi St. John's, maybe not having the type of year that they did a year ago, but still an outstanding year for the Blue Jays. As they are now heading into tonight's action, they were 3-0 and 7-2 overall, whereas the Raiders 6-1, they are 10-1. They are half a game behind Fort Laramie in the SCAL.
Yeah, Laramie, as we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, beating the Raiders earlier in the season, as Rushi's one and only loss this year. And once again, that was a close game. And if I remember right, it went into overtime and was only decided by, I think, 4 or 5 points. So that was a good battle between Laramie and Rushi earlier a couple weeks ago.
Well, let's quickly run down the starting lineups here tonight for the first off for the visitors from Rushi.
The Rushi Raiders, number 3 in the state polls that came out this week. Their overall 10-1 record in the Shelby County League, as we mentioned earlier, 6-1. They are coached by Paul Brigham. At a guard, number 10 will be Kyle Gale. He's a 6-foot senior. Jay Borchers will be a 5'11 junior. He'll wear number 22. Number 34 will be Danny Elsass, a 6'2 senior. Number 44 will be Cody Francis, a 6'2 junior. And number 50, the big man inside, Nathan Marshall, a 6'5 senior for the Rushi Raiders.
For the Houston Wildcats, coached by longtime coach John Willoughby, Adam Brock, number 5, a 5'11 senior. Jordan Richardson, a 6'3 senior, will be wearing 22. Dustin Grubbs, dressed in number 24, a 6'4 senior. Jesse Johnson, number 32, a 5'11 senior. And Kyle Brandewey, a 6'4 senior, is wearing number 50. And having graduated from Ansonia, Brandewey is not a name that's necessarily tied to Houston, but Shelby County, definitely.
Definitely. Fort Laramie has a lot of Brandeweys up there. One of the better players to come out, Tom Brandewey, went to Ohio State, but he's, as you mentioned, not one of the known names for Houston, but they've got one here tonight. It'll be Francis and Richardson to jump, and the ball will be controlled by Rushi. It'll be a man-to-man defense by Houston. In the right corner, Elsass has it for Rushi. Lost his dribble. Now he's going to throw it, and it'll be an over and back call on Rushi. A turnover for the Raiders.
And that's uncharacteristic of a Paul Brummagen-type team coming out, and usually they play a very set-type offense, and no different tonight, but turning it over right away.
Jesse Johnson, the 5'11 senior, will bring it up. Has it on the right wing. Looks inside. Man-to-man by Rushi, and we're going to have a foul inside on Rushi. That'll be on number 50, Nathan Marshall. That'll be his first and the team's first.
Marshall playing a little combination, playing behind him, but fronting him with that front right arm.
Ball be thrown out of bounds by Adam Brock, and the turnover will go to Rushi. 0-0 here, 7:26 remains here in this first quarter. Kyle Gill will bring it up for Rushi. Marshall has it on the right baseline. Waits for the offense to go through, and another turnover by Rushi, another over and back. Two turnovers on two possessions for the Rushi Raiders.
Now, we were talking about this on the way over. Of course, we've already aired some Versailles basketball games, boys basketball games, and Kyle Gale for Versailles, and it's Kyle Gill for Rushi.
Be very difficult tonight to keep those two straight, even though Gale is not here. Houston has it, top of the key. Three-pointer by Brock off the back iron is no good, and Marshall will run down the rebound. We're tied at zero still with 6:50 and counting remaining. Jay Borchers has it for Rushi. And Rushi will reset the offense. Gill will reset it. Borchers has a three-pointer left side. Gets that one to rattle home. It's 3-0 in favor of Rushi. Shot looked like it was attempted by Brandewee, but it's going to be knocked out of bounds off Rushi, and it will remain Houston ball. Dustin Grubbs will inbound it for Houston. 3-0, Rushi leads, 6:15 remaining here in this first half. Grubbs leaves it off for Richardson. Now to Johnson, and now to Brandewee. Brandewee's going to put it on the floor, puts it high off the glass, no good. Rebound tipped, now on the floor, and Rushi comes away with it, and Jay Borchers. Gill will push it up the floor, goes up for the layup, up and good. Gill with his first 2 points, and it's a 5-0 lead in favor of Rushi. Brock loses the handle on it, and it goes out of bounds off his hand, and it'll be Rushi ball. And now Houston will call a timeout. Coach John Willoughby not very happy, down 5-0 with a turnover so far in this game.
Kind of an interesting matchup, those Brandewee and Marshall pairing up defensively against each other, and especially on the Houston offensive end, a little pushing and shoving taking place, trying to kind of feel each other out and find out what they can and can't do against each other.
Shelby County League basketball is very physical at times, and a lot of times you'll see high scoring. Houston believes they need to keep this low scoring game to come out and win this one. They lost the earlier matchup 70-50 that took place earlier this year. So Houston looking to get the win here on their home court. They trail 5-0. Gill looked for the backdoor lob, couldn't get it, and they'll hand it off to Marshall. He puts it on the floor, goes up off the glass, no good. But he will be fouled by Houston's number 50, Kyle Brandewee.
That time Marshall getting the better of Kyle Brandewee. Well, after the first two teams getting our first three possessions get right down to it. Rushi turning it over twice and Houston once. They've both kind of settled down.
Marshall misses the first one. Looking to extend this lead to 6-0 with this free throw pending. Nathan Marshall does connect on that free throw. Makes it a 6-0 lead with 5:23 and counting remaining here in this first half. Now a little zone trap by Rushi, and it causes a Houston turnover. The referee brings the ball to the sideline. Looks like something is on the ball, so he'll take a towel and he'll wipe it off as he talks to the Rushi coaches.
Looking at the Dayton Daily News, at the time of this taping, Rushi ranked not only third in the state, but they're ranked third in Division IV in the Miami Valley as well, the Dayton area.
Elsass at the top of the key. He'll swing it over to his senior, Gill. Now Francis puts it up and rattles that one home for Rushi. They've got an 8-0 lead. with 4:55 remaining. Rushi goes back to the zone. Brock thought about the three, but he's going to shuffle the feet before putting the ball on the ground. Another turnover for Houston. 8-0, they trail.
That was a time where probably should have went ahead and taken the three-pointer.
Elsass at the top of the key. He'll wait for Borges. Looks back door. Nothing there. Now swing it over to Gill along the right baseline. Borges has it. He's going to go up for the layup, and he's going to draw a foul. Actually, we're going to have an offensive foul on Jay Borges, as Kyle Brandon, we stayed in there and took the charge. And that's Borchers' first foul and the team's second.
Looked like Borchers that time just got in his head that that's what he wanted to do and picked up the charge.
Austin will bring it up. Kicks it along the baseline. Dustin Grubbs has it. He'll kick it over to Jesse Johnson. Richardson has it on the right. Now top, back to Johnson. Johnson will throw up the thumb and set up a play. Gives it to Richardson. Back to Johnson. Dustin Grubbs gets to the top of the key, and he is going to be fouled by Cody Francis. And that'll be Cody's first, team's third. 8-0, Houston trails. 3:57 remains here in this first half. Dustin Grubbs at the top of the key. He'll swing it over to Johnson. Going inside to Richardson. He goes up the shot, partially blocked. Ball's loose on the floor, and Jay Borchers comes away with it. Now Houston gets a steal. Brandon Wheel put it off the glass and in, and Houston finally on the board, 8-2 with 3:38 remaining. Borchers on the right wing, kicks it in the corner. On the floor, Cody Francis has it, and he's going to be fouled by Kyle Brandewee, and that'll be Brandewee's second, and the team's second. And Cody Francis will be going to the line to shoot two, as the Raiders lead 8-2.
Looked like a good defensive effort by Houston as they knocked the ball away from Francis, but Francis somehow came up with it and then was fouled.
In for Houston, number 20, Derek Grubbs. Cody Francis, a 6'2 junior, misses the second free throw. Elsass comes away with the rebound. Borchers going to penetrate in the middle, goes up the layup, off the glass, and good. Jay Borchers now with 5 points, 11-2. Houston trails, and we're going to have a turnover by Houston as it goes off Jordan Richardson's leg, and Rushi will get it on their own half of the court. Danny Elsass inbounds it, and he'll give it to Kyle Gill. Under 3 minutes here remaining in this first quarter. Gill goes baseline, going to put it up. It's blocked, though, by Richardson, and Grubbs comes away with it. He'll hand it off to Johnson. Derek Grubbs now back to Jesse Johnson. Gives it to Adam Brock. And now we're going to have a foul on Jay Borchers, a little reach-in foul against Brock. And that'll be Jay Borchers' second foul, the team's fourth. So Rushi's got just one player with two fouls, and that's Jay Borchers.
That time got caught playing defense with his hands rather than with his feet.
He'll take a seat, Borchers will, and Lee Rosenbeck, a 5'11 junior, will check in for the Raiders, who lead 11-2, 2:30 remaining here in this first half. Dustin Grubbs puts it on the floor, and he's going to be held by Rushi's Lee Rosenbeck. It'll be his first foul, and the team fifth, and it'll be a common foul, and Houston will inbound it. Grubb has it from 14 foot off the front of the rim, no good. Loose rebound comes down to Elsass. 11-2, Rushi leads. with 2:09 remaining here in this first half. Gill's going to put it on the floor, goes up for the shot, rattles that one home, and gets fouled. Kyle Gill with 4 points. He'll go to the line for one more. And the foul went on number 32, Jesse Johnson, his first. And John Willoughby will take his second timeout of this first quarter.
And this one being a full timeout, so wants to go into a little more in-depth conversation with his players. 13-2 is the score as Rushi leads Houston in the Shelby County Athletic League game. And right now, not a whole lot of need for rebounding, but Rushi holding a 3-1 edge at this point.
Paul Brigham very happy with his Rushi Raiders right now with a 13-2 lead. Kyle Gill has 4 points for the Raiders. Jay Borchers with 5 points, but with two personal fouls, some head coach Brigham didn't really want to see with his co-captains, with two fouls here early in this first quarter.
Well, the first being a charge is knew what he wanted to do, had a good idea, but just maybe a little out of control heading down the lane.
Gill will go to the line for one free throw off the made layup. 2:05 remains here in this first half. Gill, the 6-foot senior, connects on the free throw. And Rushi will put a full court press on. Brock turns over the ball. And then Lee Rosenbeck puts it in and gets fouled.
Well, Rosenbeck, a big spark off the bench thus far as he replaced Borchers, but leading the point on the full court press, comes up with a steal and a basket.
Rosenbeck's free throw is good. And the full court pressure goes back on, 17-2, the Rushi Raiders lead. Turnover by Adam Brock as he tried to force it inside to Dustin Grubbs. Back the other way, Gill loses the handle on it. And Brock will come away with it. Everybody clears out for Houston. Collins will go baseline, puts it up, and gets the basket to go, and he draws the foul. Foul's going to go on Danny Elsass. It'll be his first and the team's sixth. Brian Collins, a 5'9 senior, will go to the line for one. And he does connect on that one. 17-5, Rushi leads the Houston Wildcats. Gill penetrates down the middle, off the back iron, no good. Comes away with the rebound. It's Cody Francis. He puts it up. It's blocked by Richardson, and Adam Brock will run it down. Brock pushes it up the near side, kicks it in the right side, back to Brock. Brock, three-pointer. He gets nothing but the bottom of the net and makes it a 17-8 game. In favor of the Rushi Raiders with 1:10 remaining here in this first quarter.
One thing Houston doesn't want, they've already dug themselves a deep hole, but they don't want to make it any worse than it is. And a couple three-pointers and they're back in this.
Gill penetrates into the middle, goes up, a little 10-footer floater, no good. Loose ball is going to be run down by Cody Francis, and he loses the handle on it to Dustin Grubbs. And Brock will bring it up for the Wildcats. 38 seconds remain here in this first quarter. Collins has it. Now we're going to have a foul away from the ball. And I think it's going to go on number 44, Cody Francis. And it will. And that will be his second and the team's seventh. So Houston will be shooting free throws for the rest of this half with 33.2 seconds remaining. And a 17-8 deficit the Houston Wildcats have.
Paul Brummagen can't be too happy about that. Already sending the Wildcats to the charity stripe with this bonus.
Derek Grubbs, a 6'2 junior, will go to the line for 1-1. Makes it a 17-9 deficit. And misses on the second one. Nathan Marshall comes away with the rebound for the Raiders. Under 30 seconds remaining here in this first quarter. Rushi will look for the last shot, most likely here. 20 seconds remaining. Nathan Marshall now in the corner to Kevin Tebby. Tebby picks up his dribble, looking to give it to somebody. It's knocked away by Houston. Loose ball still on the floor. Ball comes away to Tebby. 3 seconds remain. Tebby's going to go baseline, puts up. It's blocked by Richardson, out of bounds as the quarter ends. 17-9, Houston trails the Rushi Raiders. Here on Adelphia Cable System, Channel 6, Channel 11, and Channel 18.
Helping bring you this event, the Made Right Sandwich Shop, located on North Broadway in Greenville by the Ansonia Lumber Company on Main Street in Ansonia, Gilbert Feller's Funeral Home located in Brookville, Greenville National Bank with several locations in Dark County, by Cox Insurance located in Ansonia and Greenville, by Homestretch Sportswear located in St. Henry and Wapakoneta, and by M. Bixler Video Productions. Helping bring you this event, by Oliver Floyd Funeral Home in Greenville, Montage Cafe on Broadway in Greenville, by McCain Painting Incorporated, located in Greenville, by Osgood State Bank, located in Osgood, Family Health Services in Greenville, Arcanum, Versailles, and New Madison, by State Farm Insurance, your agent, Jim Gable, and by M. Bixler Video Productions.
Welcome back to Houston, where the Houston Wildcats trail the Rushi Raiders 17-9. Inside for Houston, Dustin Grubbs misses the shot. Marshall comes away with the rebound, and Jay Borchers will bring it up for the Raiders. Borchers' three-pointer from the right side wing, around the rim, no good, rattles out. And coming away with the rebound is Marshall. He'll hand it to Tebby. He thought about the three, decided against it. And now Borchers will reset the offense for the Raiders. Borchers' three-pointer, airballed, partially blocked maybe. Actually just left it short, and it'll be a turnover for Rushi. Houston will bring it up. They trail 17-9. Collins on the right wing, going to go baseline. Double team there, kicks it out. Brock has it, top of the key. Now the Dustin Grubbs. Back to Brock off the pick, three-pointer short. And Rosenbeck will come away with the rebound for the Raiders, who lead 17-9.
As far, Rushi dominating the boards, 8-3.
Rosenbeck throws it up left-handed, no good. And the ball's going to come out to Borchers. He'll put up a 16-footer, gets that one to go. Borchers now with 7 points, 19-9. Rushi leads over the Houston Wildcats. 18-footer from Derek Grubbs was no good. And now we're going to have a foul on number 30, Brian Collins. It'll be his first and the team's fifth.
Just a little late in getting there. Rushi player getting there just about a half a second before.
Jay Borchers gives it to Elsass. Elsass, three-pointer from the right side is good. Danny, with his first 3 points of the night, gives the Raiders a 22-9 lead, just under six remains in this second quarter. Shot is going to be good by Jesse Johnson off the good fake. Got his defender up in the air. Cuts it to 11-point deficit, 22-11 in favor of Rushi. Danny Elsass with his foot on the line. Shot's no good. and Dustin Grubbs comes away with it. Jesse Johnson, three-pointer top of the key, no good. And we're going to have a dead ball as Rushi's Nathan Marshall took an elbow from, I think it was Dustin Grubbs.
Well, I didn't see what happened. I was writing down a rebound, and all of a sudden I heard this, oh!
Dustin Grubbs holding his right elbow, and when he came down with that rebound, he swung it a little bit, and I think he caught Nathan Marshall a little more than he wanted to. Inside Cody Francis, partially blocked, maybe left a little short, but Francis gets it back, puts it up off the glass, no good. Elsass, 15-footer, off the back iron, no good. Marshall comes away with it, but we are going to have...
And we're going to have a delay in game as this game has gotten very physical. And with blood on the floor, that's got to be cleaned up. So both teams are going to be sent to the bench. You can just about bet that. John Willoughby having a discussion with one of the officials.
I think who went to the restroom or to the locker room. He went straight. As soon as he got hit, he was bleeding pretty bad. And Derek Grubbs, the 6'2 junior, I think, is who went to the locker room for Houston. And once again, it's still blood down on the floor. You can see a couple drops.
Oh, more than a couple.
And they'll bring the mop out to clean it up. As Rushi leads 22-11 with 5:02 remaining here in the second quarter.
Now John Willoughby has left the bench to go in and check on his young man.
Rushi has decided to take a seat on their bench. Houston is now will have five players as they'll have a substitution in for Grubbs. As an assistant coach, we'll talk to his player or talk to the Houston Wildcats.
I did not catch the number actually, but it's a situation that you don't like to see, of course, on. Greenville Public Access Television, Greenville and Salina. Last Saturday, we had a situation where a young lady had to have seven stitches, Nicole Harrison, and that happened late in the first quarter, as now they bring out the
John Willoughby.
I'm not sure what they call that, but...
It's like a disinfectant,
yes,
that they have to use...
And I was surprised that they mopped up the blood because now they don't know where.
Yeah. John Willoughby had stepped out of the locker room and now he's back in. But, yeah, I don't – to wipe up the blood and then not know where it's at now.
You now almost have to disinfect that whole baseline and part of the floor area.
You see many of the Houston managers – ball boys down on their hands and knees with towels cleaning it up.
I can remember a few years ago doing high school basketball or Dayton Christian games on WFCJ. It was the regional semifinals, Dayton Christian against Bell Fountain, and a young man from Bell Fountain just took a similar situation, an elbow, and wasn't caught immediately, and there was a delay of about 20 minutes. That's tough on a broadcaster.
Yes, I'm sure it's very tough. As you can kind of see here, it's still very tough.
I can go back, and this was even tougher. This was not a blood situation. It was a game, high school basketball game that I was doing on a radio station at that time, too, in the old WDRK in Greenville, and down at Franklin Monroe. A young man, a severe leg injury, And until the they had to keep him on the floor until the ambulance got there. And by the time they got out, it was a good half an hour.
Well, it looks like they're going to resume play.
Well, not yet. They've got to get like some disinfect on that far baseline.
Players have returned to the floor. Referees decide to check out the floor and see.
Making sure that there's nothing there, and they're not seeing anything, so we are just about ready to resume play. Back to you, Scott.
Well, Rushi will have the ball underneath their own basket. They lead 22-11 with 5:02 remaining. From the left baseline, shot was by Francis, was no good, and Richardson pulls down the rebound for the Wildcats. Johnson will bring it up. Looks inside. Goes up for the shot. Is the 6'4 senior Dustin Grubbs. He gets that to go, and he draws the foul also on Rushi's Nathan Marshall, and that'll be his second foul. So Rushi has three players with two fouls, and Nathan Marshall, Cody Francis, and Jay Borchers here in this first half. Now the referee's going to bring
Richardson over, and I would be willing to bet he might have some blood on his uniform. On the backside, that's exactly where it is.
So he will have to go in and change shorts.
Yes. Now, if it's a top, you can change tops. Just change with one of the other players. But the shorts, that's a little different story. That, by the way, on the other end, Grubbs did a nice job of posting up on the low block, but that was a nice entry pass by Jesse Johnson as well.
So now Coach Willoughby will have to come back in. Will have to send a player in for and it'll be number 44, Dusty Reisinger. A 6'2 junior. So Grubbs will go to the line to shoot one. He's got 2 points, looking to make it three. And rattles around the rim, no good. Elsass will bring down the ball. 4:40 remains here in this first half, 22-13. Rushi leads over the Houston Wildcats. Borchers guarded by Brock. Now over to Gill. Gill's going to go baseline. Kicks it out. Cross court to Elsass. He'll put up a three-pointer on the near wing. No good, but we're going to have a rebound by Brian Collins, and then he gets fouled. A good box out by the 5'9 senior. And it'll go on. Looked like number 42 for Rushi. But we're thinking it's Luke Cardonier.
We'll double check that at the half. By the way, stay tuned as the newly crowned homecoming queen here at Houston. We'll be talking with her at halftime. We would talk to the king, but he's going to be in the locker room.
As he was changing shorts just a little bit ago. And Collins made the first one, but missed the second one. And Rushi will come away with the ball. 22-14, they lead. 4:10 remaining here in the second quarter. Borchers is going to shuffle the feet as he came to a stop, and his right foot just scooted along a little more. And it'll be a turnover for Rushi. Houston looking to cut into this 8-point deficit with 4:07 remaining.
Houston's got to find a way to cut off Rushi from the offensive boards. Right now they're being out-rebounded 15-6, but 8 of those are offensive rebounds.
Jesse Johnson gets the shot to go. He's got 4 points this evening. 22-16, Rushi leads. Rebound comes down to Cody Francis underneath the basket. He goes up for the shot, but he's going to get a foul. And that's going to go on number 32.
And it's
Jesse Johnson for his second foul. Pardon me.
9 offensive rebounds by Rushi here in the first half.
Cody Francis connects on the free throw. He's 2 of 3 on the night. Rosenbeck and Richardson check in for Rushi. Francis misses the second one. 23-16, Houston trails. Brock goes in, leaves it long, ball's loose. Comes away to Francis, and he'll kick it up to Borchers. Borchers on the floor, loses the handle, but gets it up to Gill. Gill to Rosenbeck, and he's going to be fouled by Houston's Jesse Johnson. And that'll be Johnson's third personal foul of this half.
Kyle Gill did a nice job. He penetrated the lane and saw, is that Rosenbeck?
I think it is Rosenbeck.
Rosenbeck, yeah, on the low post and just dished it off to him. And, of course, Rosenbeck drew the foul at that point.
Rosenbeck connects on his first of the one and one. He's 2 of 2 from the charity stripe tonight. Make it 3 of 3 for the 5'11 junior. 25-16, Brucey leads over Houston. 3:15 remains here in the second half. Richardson gets it to Collins. He thought about the three, decided not. Brucey has switched to a pressure zone, looks like. Collins going to go baseline now, back it out. Cross court to Grubbs. Goes baseline, leaves it short, gets his own rebound, and puts it back in. Dustin Grubbs, that is, now with 4 points on the evening. 25-18, Houston trails with 2:46 remaining.
Brucey with 9 offensive rebounds. That offensive rebound was the first one by Houston.
Gill's going to penetrate in, goes off the shot. It's blocked, though. Brucey retains possession off the back iron, no good. And Dusty Reisinger will bring it down for Houston. And Houston will walk it up the court slowly as they trail 25-18. Grubb gets it into Richardson. Richardson goes up against Elsass off the back of the glass. No good. Ball's quickly up the court. Francis with the right-handed layup. No good. But Borchers there. No good. And Dustin Grubbs comes away with the rebound. Quickly back the other way. Collins has it on the near wing. Goes up, 14-footer, no good. Gets the glass and nothing else. But we're going to have a held jump ball underneath, and it will be Rushi ball. .148 and counting remaining here in the second quarter, 25-18. Rushi leads. Kyle Gill, little floater from inside left. That one's short. Barely got the front of the iron, but Borchers comes away with the loose ball rebound. And now Kyle Gill will reset it for Rushi.
Looks like they're spreading the floor a little bit.
Rushi probably going to wait for the last shot. As I bite my tongue on that one, Lee Rosenbeck's shot, three-pointer, no good. Houston trails 25-18. 103 remains here in this second quarter. And Adam Brock throws that one right past Dustin Grubbs. A turnover for Houston.
After a sloppily played first quarter, this one has kind of settled down. Brucey with 6 turnovers for the half thus far with 1 minute remaining, and Houston with 5.
Houston fans come to their feet. Under a minute remains as Kyle Gill walks it up the court for the Raiders. Ball over to Tebby. He loses the handle, gets it back inside to Brucey, and we're going to have a foul on number 5, Adam Brock, and that'll be his first personal in the team's 8th.
Well, Rushi's really settled down in this ball game. They had 7 fouls late in the first quarter, and they've only committed 2 since that point. And we have just over 45 seconds remaining in the half.
26-18. Raiders lead with the free throw pending. They get 27-18, 45 seconds remain and counting here. Brock swings it over to Dustin Grubbs. He goes baseline, puts it up off the glass. A great bank shot there by Dustin Grubbs. He's got six on the evening. 26 seconds remain. Rushi leads by seven, 27-20.
Well, you can just guarantee they're going for the last shot now.
Rushi will go into their four-corner offensive play as they'll try and pull Rushi out of their zone, and now Rushi will stay in their zone, actually. With 6 seconds remaining, Gill gets it over to Elsass. He'll put up a three-pointer. Short, no good. As the shot will not be held off, or will not go off, as time will expire here in the first half with a score of 27-20 in favor of the Rushi Raiders.
Helping bring you this event, the Made Right Sandwich Shop, located on North Broadway in Greenville, by the Ansonia Lumber Company on Main Street in Ansonia, Gilbert Feller's Funeral Home located in Brookville, Greenville National Bank with several locations in Dark County, by Cox Insurance located in Ansonia and Greenville, by Homestretch Sportswear located in St. Henry and Wapakoneta, and by M. Bixler Video Productions. Helping bring you this event, by Oliver Floyd Funeral Home in Greenville, Montage Cafe on Broadway in Greenville, by McCain Painting Incorporated, located in Greenville, by Osgood State Bank, located in Osgood, Family Health Services in Greenville, Arcanum, Versailles, and New Madison, by State Farm Insurance, your agent, Jim Gable, and by M. Bixler Video Productions.
And we're back here at Houston. It's a 27-20 lead for the Rushi Raiders over the Houston Wildcats. And earlier tonight, it was homecoming here at Houston. And with me is Tricia Slusser, the newly crowned homecoming queen here at Houston. And Tricia, what was it like when you were crowned homecoming queen tonight?
I was surprised. It was very exciting to think that people my age would pick me to represent our school as homecoming queen.
You're pretty active in school. We talked a little bit during the JV game. You said that you were in the FFA and some things like that.
I'm also an FCCLA Muse Machine, and I partake in the host program who travels to our elementary school to mentor the younger kids.
That's pretty exciting, being able to do something like that. What's that like?
It's a challenge at times, but it's interesting, and it helps them. We do like reading. We help them read.
Well, again, congratulations on being crowned homecoming queen, and we would talk with the king as well, but unfortunately he's in the locker room right now, so congratulations, Tricia.
Thanks.
Right now, let's switch it up top to Scott Ward, and he'll go through the statistics.
Well, first of all, for the Houston Wildcats, as they trailed 27-20 to the Rushi Raiders. First of all, they are led by Dustin Grubbs, a 6'4 senior. He's got 6 points on the evening. Adam Brock has 4 points. Brian Collins with three. Jesse Johnson with 4 points. Kyle Brandewey with two. And Derek Grubbs with 1 point in the first half. For the Rushi Raiders, they are led by Jay Borchers, even though he's got two fouls. 7 points for Jay Borchers. Kyle Gill with 5 points. Lee Rosenbeck has five here in the first half. Danny Elsass, 3 points. Cody Francis with four. Nathan Marshall with one. And Luke Cardonier also has two in this first half for a score of 27. Once again, 27-20 is your score here at halftime. Rushi leads the Houston Wildcats.
Helping bring you this event, the Made Right Sandwich Shop, located on North Broadway in Greenville, by the Ansonia Lumber Company on Main Street in Ansonia, Gilbert Feller's Funeral Home located in Brookville, Greenville National Bank with several locations in Dark County, by Cox Insurance, located in Ansonia and Greenville, by Homestretch Sportswear, located in St. Henry and Wapakoneta, and by M. Bixler Video Productions. Helping bring you this event, by Oliver Floyd Funeral Home in Greenville, Montage Cafe on Broadway in Greenville, by McCain Painting Incorporated, located in Greenville, by Osgood State Bank, located in Osgood, Family Health Services in Greenville, Arcanum, Versailles, and New Madison, by State Farm Insurance, your agent, Jim Gable, and by M. Bixler Video Productions.
We're back here at Houston, 27-20 the score. The Rushi Raiders leading Houston. And, Scott, one thing that Houston, they've got to figure out a way to keep Rushi off the offensive boards if they want to win this ball game. Rushi with 13 of 23 rebounds, 13 of them were offensive rebounds.
Well, earlier in the week, John Willoughby said that Houston was doing a good job of going to the boards in their past couple games. In practice, they were doing a good job. And he really likes his board go-getters. Jordan Richardson can go to the boards. He doesn't have any points tonight, as Jesse Johnson also can go to the boards. A 6'4 senior, Kyle Brandewey, only with 2 points. So as you said, they need to get going to the boards a little more. They're very lucky right now only to be down 27-20. They get 1 point. This was, I think, an 11-point deficit.
Well, actually, it might have been a little more than that. It was at least 14-2 at one time, and maybe even 16 or 17-2.
Well, Houston will retain possession in the second half as the ball is knocked out of bounds by Jay Borchers of Rushi. 27-20. Once again, Rushi leads Houston. Jesse Johnson for the Wildcats will penetrate in the middle, puts up the shot around the rim and no good, but he will draw the foul from Rushi defender, and it looks like it's going to be on number 50, Nathan Marshall. That'll be his third and the team's first of this half.
And that's exactly what Houston has to do. They have to take it right at the Raiders.
Jesse Johnson, a 5'11 senior with 4 points in the first half. Now he's got five on the evening.
Trailing 25-18 late in the first half. In the second quarter, Rushi had two or three opportunities to trim into that Houston lead, or the Houston had two or three opportunities to trim into the Rushi lead, but just never seemed to be able to do that. And of course, Rushi went up 27-20 at the half.
Now a 5-point lead for Rushi. Top of the key for Rushi. Cody Francis with a foot on the line gets a two. I think official sign from the referee. It goes two on the scoreboard. 29-22, Rushi leads.
Paul Brummagen, the head coach of Rushi, wanted the three on that one.
Andy Brock way downtown. Brandewey comes away with the rebound, puts it up and in. He's got four in the evening. Back to a 5-point deficit for the Wildcats.
And a key, that is the second offensive rebound, but the first by either team here in the second half.
And as Danny Alsace turns the ball over, Houston can cut into this lead even more of Rushi's. 29-24, Houston trails here in Houston. It's a great Shelby County League rivalry takes place. Grubbs is going to go baseline, puts up a little floater off the rim, no good. Francis down with the rebound. Gill will push it up. 3-on-3. Gill goes down the middle. And he's going to run over a Houston player. And Kyle Brandewey, Paul Brigham, doesn't like that call. But Gill will get his first personal and the team's second of this half. Houston trails. 6:30 remains in the third quarter. Johnson, Jesse Johnson, now over to Brock. Brock's going to go baseline, puts it up and in through the net. He's got six, and it's now a 3-point deficit for Houston. Francis on the left wing, thought about the three, decided against it. Marshall, now to Elsass, guarded by Richardson.
in the corner to Francis. Cross court, and it's going to be thrown out of bounds as Francis tried to get it to a cutting Marshall. And a turnover for Rushi. And Houston can tie this game with a three-pointer or cut it to a one-point deficit with just under 6 minutes to go in the third quarter.
And that's the third turnover for Rushi here in the second half.
Grubbs is going to penetrate, try to get to Richardson, but Richardson was able to run down that loose ball. Jesse Johnson on the near wing to Brandewee. Johnson's going to penetrate, goes up a little floater around the defender and Marshall, and it's a one-point deficit now as Johnson connects on that two-pointer. Quickly back the other way. Gale comes away with it. Ball stolen by Houston, and we're going to have a foul on Danny Elsass as he's stripped the ball, got a little hand, and that'll be his second and the team's third.
Well, right now, the momentum has definitely switched sides. It's now wearing white trimmed in red.
Exactly right. Houston with two free throws here pending after this timeout. We'll be able, if they connect on both of them, we'll take the first lead of the night after trailing Rushi early in this ball game, and it was really really ugly at first.
At first, exactly. Both teams, as we mentioned in the first half, came out, it was rather very sloppily played in the first quarter especially, but uncharacteristic for Rushi. They had five turnovers in the first 5-6 minutes of the first half, starting out the same way here in the second half with four turnovers. And a big thing, Rushi out-rebounded Houston 23-11 in the first half. Second half right now, it's 1-1, and Rushi with one defensive rebound, Houston with their lone rebound, an offensive rebound.
Houston on a 6-2 run here in this third quarter. I pardon myself, as that Houston will take it out of bounds instead of free throws. Dustin Grubbs will inbound it, and he will get it to Adam Brock. Brock on the near wing. Cross court to Grubbs. He's going to put it on the floor. Back to Brock. Rob Johnson against Borchers. Borchers with three personals. And the ball is going to be stolen by Cody Francis. Cody's going to go all the way coast to coast, off the glass, and good. And it's a 31-28 lead for Rushi. Back the other way, Brandewee on the left block. Gets it to Richardson. Back to Johnson. Brock's going to go for the little floater. No good. Brandewee kicks it to Marshall as Brandewee went up for the rebound. Gale gets to Elsass. Elsass three-pointer knocked to the floor. No call. Houston comes away with the rebound. Dustin Grubbs fights it away from Rushi. 31-28. 4:18 remains in the third quarter. Houston trails by three. Brandewee loses the handle on it as it goes out of bounds. Looked like he was calling for a holding call, but doesn't get a call, and it will be Rushi ball.
I want to add that the young man that took the elbow in the first half, Derek Grubbs, is back on the bench and looks like he's being tended to, and he may come back in.
Getting bandages put on, look like is right above his eyebrow, and he's got some ice on it. 31-28, Rushi leads, and they have the ball. Luke Cardonier is at the Gill. As Rosenbeck loses the handle on it, it's going to be knocked out of bounds as Grubbs and Rosenbeck fight for it, and it goes out of bounds off Grubbs' hands as Collins will check in for Jesse Johnson.
You know, during pregame, we talked about three of the tougher conferences in the small school divisions with the Midwest Athletic Conference, the Shelby County Athletic League, and the Putnam County League. And one thing that those three conferences have in common is they all play a very physical brand of basketball.
And we have seen it here tonight. Early in the second quarter, has a couple players go down as Cardonier three-pointed from the left side. Knocks down that one. His first three-pointer. Luke now with 5 points. And John Willoughby jumps off the bench and calls a quick timeout as the lead now is back up to 6, 34-28 with 3:17 remaining here in the third quarter.
Well, after Houston's 6-2 run, Rushi now on a 5-0 run.
A game of runs basketball is, and a lot of times you'll see it float from one team to the other. And there really is no home court advantage here. Rushi just down the road from Houston. Once again, Shelby County League basketball, big rivals. You know, there really is no one main rival against these where, you know, you take a look at the middle, you know, the MAC conference. Maybe you got Coldwater and St. Henry. But in this league, every team is after every team.
That's back door. I mean, you know, every school is like St. Henry Coldwater where they're maybe 2 or 3 miles apart.
Only takes 5 minutes to get to one of these schools where, you know, you take Versailles Delphus, takes you a good hour to get to one of the other. Houston trails 34-28. They'll have the ball. Quickly up the court, Brandon off the glass and good. A nice job by the Wildcats to push that one up the floor. They trail 34-30. Brandewee's got 6. Ball goes out of bounds, and it's going to go off of Kyle Brandewee's hands, are going to say. One referee looked at the other one, and they both agreed that it should go to Rushi. El Sasso inbound, it gets to Borchers. A turnaround jumper, fade shot goes for Jay Borchers. And he's got 9 for the Raiders, 36-30. Lead back to 6 now with 2:43 remaining in the third quarter. Lob goes into Brandewee, but it's stolen by Cardonier. Too hard of a pass. Gill's going to go coast to coast. Off the glass too hard. Grubbs comes away with the rebound. Adam Brock kicks it on the left block to Brandewee. Gets that jumper to go. Kyle Brandewee now with 8 on the evening. Back to a 4-point deficit for the Wildcats. Grubbs comes away with the rebound. Hands it off to Brock. Brock, 3-pointer, left wing. Short, no good. But Grubbs comes away with it, puts it off the high glass. No good, too long. And the ball trying to be saved by Kyle Brandewee, but he was standing along the baseline. And it will be Rushi ball.
And checking back in is Derek Grubbs. You're always glad to see that when somebody hurt earlier in the ball game is able to return and play.
1:50 remains here in this third quarter. You're watching basketball from Houston on Channel 6 Slina, of Channel 11 Versailles, and Channel 18 Minster on Adelphia Cable. 36-32. Rushi leads the Wildcats of Houston with 1:40 remaining in the third quarter. Ball goes into Borchers on the left block. He's underneath the basket. Tough shot. Partially blocked. And away comes Derek Grubbs for Houston. Three-pointer left wing. As Coach Willoughby doesn't like that shot as he was trying to slow it down. And Rushi will bring it up, leading by 4. Back the other way, Borchers, but he loses the handle on it, but he's going to draw a foul. And it's going to be on Adam Brock, his 2nd, and only the team's first personal of this half.
Now you look over the across the way and see all the banners up here at Houston, and you know we talked about how Rushi has made it to the state championship game a year ago, but this is a team that has done quite well for themselves as well here at Houston.
Rushi slowing it down as Houston goes for a man-to-man defense. Rosenbeck has it, puts up the shot off the side, no good, gets his own rebound, pump fakes, goes up, he's going to draw a foul on a Houston defender. And Rosenbeck will go to the line for 2. It's going to go on number 44, Dustin Reisinger, a 6'2 junior, and that'll be his 1st. Rosenbeck, 4 of 4 so far this evening from the charity stripe. As Elsass checks back in for Rushi. As does, I think it was Gilf. Rosenbeck's second free throw, also perfect. 5 of 5 of the night. He's got a total of 7 points for the Wildcats. Jesse Johnson checks in for Reisinger. Under a minute remains, 54.5 seconds to be exact. 38-32, Rushi leads over Houston. A full court pressure by Rushi. Brock has it, goes up, right-handed layup, high off the glass, too hard. Francis will come away with the rebound. And now Rushi most likely will take the last shot. Last time I said that, they hurry up and shot. And I'm pretty sure this time they will hold for the last shot.
I don't think Paul Brummagen was real happy with Lee Rosenbeck on that shot at that time either.
John Willoughby calls the timeout as he claps his hands and says he wants a timeout. No, pardon me, that was Rushi will take a timeout. It'll be a 30-second timeout. 38-32, Rushi leads over Houston. 25 seconds exactly remain here in this third quarter. And once again, just a barn burner going on here in the third quarter. A 6-point lead for the Raiders with 25 seconds remaining here in this third quarter. Another great Shelby County League basketball game taking place here in Houston.
Well, it's obvious John Willoughby talked a little bit about offensive rebounds at halftime. 13 in the first half, 1 thus far in the second.
Danny Elsass will inbound it for the Raiders at the midcourt line. Gill will bring it up for Rushi. Rushi has spread their offense. And now Houston changes their defense a little bit. 8 seconds remain. Borchers has it, going to go right baseline. Puts up a little floater off the rim, no good. And Reisinger comes away with it, throws up from half court. Oh. Just off the rim. It's no good. But at halftime, it's 38-32. The Rushi, or pardon me, at the end of the third quarter. 38-32, Rushi leads over the Houston Wildcats here on Adelphia Cable.
Helping bring you this event, the Made Right Sandwich Shop, located on North Broadway in Greenville by the Ansonia Lumber Company on Main Street in Ansonia, Gilbert Feller's Funeral Home located in Brookville, Greenville National Bank with several locations in Dark County, by Cox Insurance, located in Ansonia and Greenville, by Homestretch Sportswear, located in St. Henry and Wapakoneta, and by M. Bixler Video Productions. Helping bring you this event, by Oliver Floyd Funeral Home in Greenville, Montage Cafe on Broadway in Greenville, by McCain Painting Incorporated, located in Greenville, by Osgood State Bank, located in Osgood, Family Health Services in Greenville, Arcanum, Versailles, and New Madison, by State Farm Insurance, your agent, Jim Gable, and by M. Bixler Video Productions.
Back at Houston, 38-32, the final 8 minutes of this, at least in regulation, is just about ready to get underway. It'll be Rushi basketball. Back to you, Scott.
Thanks, Mark. As you said, Rushi basketball, 38-32. Elsass will inbound it. As this place could get very crazy and loud here in these final 8 minutes, if it continues to be like the third quarter was, a barn burner in a battle. Borchers right wing, going to penetrate, and he's going to draw a foul. It's going to be on the floor, though. No shot will count. It looks like it's going to go on number 5, Adam Brock. It will. That'll be his third personal and the team's third of this second half. Elsass tries to throw it in as his player fell down, and Lee Rosenbeck. It'll be a turnover for Rushi. Coach Willoughby doing a little offensive defense here. Brings in Jesse Johnson for Brian Collins. I seen that a little bit in the third quarter. We'll see if he continues to do that in the fourth. Brandwee over to Grubbs and Dustin Grubbs. And now we're going to have a pushing foul on Rushi. And that's going to be on number 44, Cody Francis, his third and the team's fourth of this half. Now while the delay is, the referee will just go down to the other end of the court and wipe something off the court.
Well, that's where the player slipped. Over on the sideline, they're trying to find the moisture, but
referee's got no clue as he throws his hands out.
Brad Francis, one of the assistant coaches, also the athletic director. Going over to give a helping hand.
Much to the dismay to Houston fans. Back to action. Brock gets it to Johnson. Little 10-footer short, no good. Johnson gets his rebound, puts it up short again. Loose rebound run down by Jay Borchers. 38-32, Rushi leads with 7:20 remaining here in this fourth quarter. Lee Rosenbeck looks inside to Elsatz. It's knocked away by Richardson. And Johnson will come away off the tip from Richardson.
As this game progresses, every possession is important. And that, I'm sure, not what John Willoughby wanted to see happen, because that just squandered another possession.
Turnover by Jesse Johnson. He thought it was tipped away by Rushi. But it wasn't to the eyes of the referee. 38-32, Rushi leads. Nice play by Rushi as they get a little roll, and Cody Francis gets the roll into the bucket. Francis now with 10, takes it to an 8-point lead for the Raiders, 40-32. Brock gets to Richardson, back to Brock, inside to Brandwee. Brandwee goes up off the glass, too strong, no good. Johnson pump fakes, goes up, but he's going to draw the foul. The foul will go on Jay Borchers. That'll be his third, team's fifth. And Johnson will go to the line to shoot two.
Borchers picked up two quick fouls in the first quarter. Took a seat midway through the first quarter and then came back in the second. And silent as far as committing fouls since then.
Johnson, 3-3 on the day from the charity stripe. He's got 9. 7-point lead by the Raiders with this free throw pending. He connects on that one. He's 4-4, 40-34. Rushi leads. Elsass looking inside. Actually, he's going to go baseline now. He's up for the shot, no good, but we're going to have, looks like a foul on Houston. Foul's going to be on Jordan Richardson. It's going to be his second, the team's fourth.
By the way, at halftime when interviewing Tricia Slusser, it was Jordan Richardson that we were referring to as being crowned king.
Elsass with 3 points on the night, a three-pointer. His first attempt from the charity stripe. Nathan Marshall will check in for Luke Cardonier. Cardonier, a 6-foot freshman, has seen a lot of playing time. And the Cardonier name continues to go on in Rushi. Elsass misses a second free throw. 41-34, Rushi leads.
Houston doing a much better job rebounding here in the second half.
Brandwee, nice play, coming off the pick. He puts it off the glass and good. He's got 10, cuts the lead 41-36. Borchers going to penetrate, tries to draw a foul, throw a shot up, doesn't happen. A nice play by Marshall. Nathan Marshall throws it off of, I think it was Richardson, Jordan Richardson.
Houston fans didn't think that, it did go off of one of their players, but it did.
They were on the backside and really couldn't see it, and it was a nice play by Nathan Marshall, the 6'5 senior.
I think from their angle, it looked like he just kind of flipped it around, but it went off of Richardson.
Tonight, a delay has happened many times. So Richardson ties his shoes now. Now we will be ready to go back to action. Francis with the ball. Now Gill on the right wing. Rishi running their motion offense, running some clock. Marshall hands it off to Gill. Gill's going to go baseline. He's up for the shot, but he'll draw the foul on the arm. He'll go to the line for two shots. And the foul goes on Dustin Grubbs. That'll be his first personal and the team's fifth.
For those of you watching on Adelphia Cable on Channel 6, Channel 11, and 18, depending on which system you are watching, just make sure that I want to just remind you to go in and patronize those businesses who are helping underwrite tonight's ball game, and also tell them a big thank you as well for helping sponsor the ball games.
Jay Borchers will check in for Luke Cardon here.
Now, on the way over here, we were talking about freshmen having a lot of impact this year, and how some of the coaches have brought those players along. And of course, this is our first opportunity to watch Rushi as that free throw is made. But I can't say how Coach Brumagen has brought along Luke Cardonier, but some of the other coaches have let them play JV ball early on in the season, get them acclimated to playing high school, and then bring them on late in the year.
And I think that's probably what Luke Cardonier is doing, is he was on, he played some JV ball tonight beforehand. Now he's getting a lot of playing time here in the varsity, and he's going to be a big help to this Rushi team when it does come tournament time. The foul was on Cody Francis, his fourth.
Luke Cardonier will check back in for the Raiders. Richardson missed that first free throw.
Richardson scoreless tonight, a 6'3 senior. 0 of 1 from the charity stripe, now make it 1 of 2.
Back to a 5-point game, 42-37 with 5 minutes remaining. Much closer than the first go-round with these two schools.
70-50 win by Rushi in Rushi. And Houston knew if they could keep the score low, it would be more in their favor than it would be in Rushi's. And so far they've done that, only giving up 42 points to the Raiders. Defense has been very well, especially here in the second half by Houston. Gill, a little five-footer, good. He's got 8 on the afternoon. It takes it to a 44-37 lead for the Raiders. Brock for the Wildcats, now to Johnson. Back to Brock, thinks about baseline, decides not. Rushi in a 2-3 zone. Back to Brock, three-pointer, left wing. Off the iron, no good. Gill gets it, kicks it out to Brandewey, who wasn't even expecting that ball. Johnson thought about the three, decided not as he got his defender up in the air. He'll throw up a long three-pointer, goes for the bank shot, no good. Borchers with the rebound. Quickly up the floor, 3-on-3, Borchers. Going to draw a foul. This one should be on the floor, but we'll see what referee has to say. It's going to be on Adam Brock, his fourth personal, and it was on the floor. And the team's sixth.
A full timeout being taken by the Houston Wildcats here, trailing by 7. 44-37, 3:45 remaining. And again, just a reminder for those of you watching here tonight on Adelphia Cable, Channel 6 in Salina, 11 in Versailles, and 18 in Minster. Go in and let those businesses who are underwriting the games that you are watching know that you appreciate that fact, and while you're there, patronize them.
It's always good to patronize people inside those businesses.
Now, those businesses are all basically local businesses, and
most of them owned by local people, too, which is the nicer things, especially in the small communities. That's one thing I think a lot of people like about, you know, in this area, is they're owned by, you know, local people.
Mom-and-pop type businesses.
Exactly. And, well, we're about ready for action. Once again, we're from Houston High School, 44-37. Rushi leads with 3:45 remaining here in this fourth quarter. El Sasso inbound it for the Raiders. And now he'll call a quick timeout. Good defensive job there by Houston.
And a smart move by Rushi, going ahead and taking a 30-second timeout. And 3:45, you've got a 7-point lead. And every possession means something at this point in the ballgame. You know, Rushi right now standing second place, a half game behind Fort Laramie. We'll run down the Shelby County Athletic League standings. Fort Laramie 6-0 in first place. They're 10-2 overall. Rushi is 6-1. They're second. And the Sydney paper has them at 10-1, but the Dayton paper says 11-1. So who knows on that one? Fairlawn at 4-3. The Jets are 8-5 overall. Houston tied for third with Fairlawn at 4-3, 6-6. Anna 3-4, 5-7. Jackson Center 1-6 and 4-8, and Botkins 0-7 and 2-9.
Elsass tries to throw it into Cardania, but a nice run down there by Jay Borchers to save the turnover for the Raiders. Once again, Borchers saves another one in the corner. Marshall has it off the glass and good, but before the shot, he shuffled his feet. And a very good call by the referee as he was standing right there behind him as Marshall shuffled his feet. 44-37, pardon me, Mark. 3:17 remains in this fourth quarter.
I'm not sure Paul Brummagen appreciated that call, but he did shuffle his feet, happy feet.
Collins gets the little floater to go. 4 points for him. Check at 5 points. Cuts the deficit to 44-39. Now we're going to have a turnover by Rushi.
Houston stepping it up defensively. Suddenly, as you said, with 2:57 remaining, it's a 5-point ball game, and they can trim it to three, possibly two, possibly one.
Brandon Wee, now cross court. Collins, 3-pointer around the rim and knocks that one down. Brian Collins with 9 now, 44-42. 2:37 remains in this fourth quarter. Collins left wide open on the left wing, took the shot, and got it to fall. Borchers trying to match that three-pointer. Off the rim, no good. Brandewey with the rebound, and we're going to have an over-the-back foul called on Nathan Marshall. It's going to be his fourth, the team's seventh. So we'll go to the other end, and we'll shoot free throws.
That is the seventh team foul against Rushi.
We'll be shooting free throws the rest of this game. Houston with 16 fouls, Rushi with 7, as you mentioned, Mark. And Brandewey will go to the line. He hasn't been there tonight. He's got 10 points.
A chance to right now make it a 1-point ball game.
And he does that. And now he can tie it. Don't think it's been tied all night.
I don't think it has. Before, we definitely have not had a lead change.
And it's tied. 44 all, 2:18 remains. Both crowds come to their feet. Brandewey with 12. Rushi will slow it down. Borchers now on the right wing. He's going to penetrate in the middle. Little 12-footer off the back iron. No good. Gets his own rebound. Actually, it slips through his hands. Johnson comes away with the rebound.
Houston to take their first lead of the night. Remember, Rushi got off to that quick 7-0 lead.
Coach Willoughby telling his troops to be patient. Grubbs along the baseline. Alders the shot, no good, but gets his own rebound, and they'll pull it back out. Houston will. 1:30 remains in this fourth quarter. Grubbs leaves it to Brandewey. Brandewey on the baseline, kicks it out. Johnson thought about the three, decided not. Penetrates in the middle. A floater from 12-foot. Go. Johnson, he's got 12 now. Houston takes their first lead of the night. Gill back the other way. Goes for the shot. No good. We're going to go to the charity stripe. Gill will. We're going to have a blocking foul. And it's going to go on Jesse Johnson. That'll be his fourth. The team's seventh.
I think Brian Collins. Took a blow to the midsection.
He is hurting as he comes off holding his stomach and will take a seat directly on the bench as he is hurting, as you mentioned. 108 remains here in the fourth quarter. 46-44, Houston leads. Gill will go to the line. He's been there for three shots. He's connected on two. Make it three now. Three out of four on the night.
That's your typical Shelby County Athletic League nail biter.
9 points for Kyle Gill. The 6-foot senior connects on the next one. We've got another tie ball game. 46 apiece, 105 remains. Brock swings it over to Richardson. Rushi putting full pressure on Houston. Richardson going to go baseline. Back to Brock. Gets it to Johnson. He almost walked with the ball. To Brandwee. Puts it on the floor. Goes up the shot. No good. Elsass with the rebound. Elsass grabs the ball. Now we're going to have a foul on Brandwee. Brandwee's third, team's eighth. And not something John Willoughby can be very happy with. 43 seconds remain. And your team is tied with the Raiders, and now you're going to send them to the charity stripe. And Elsass is 2-2 on the night so far.
Well, it's one in bonus.
Make it 3 of 3. Elsass, 5 points. The 6'2 senior. And the seniors are definitely, so far, connecting, showing their leadership. 47-46, make it 48-46 as Elsass connects on his fourth free throw. And Rushi calls a full timeout with 43 seconds remaining. They lead 48-46. And as we mentioned in the third quarter, it was going to come down to the end, and definitely has a 2-point lead for the Rushi Raiders.
Well, as I said, it's your typical Rushi, it's your typical nail biter for a Shelby County Athletic League game. And, these are two schools with a lot of tradition. As we said earlier, Rushi taking it to the state championship game a year ago before falling to Delphi St. John's. And I pointed out, Houston, a lot of tradition here as well. 1990 regional runner-up, and as late as 1999 they made it to the regionals, falling in the regional semifinal game. But both of these schools, a lot of tradition.
And we talked about on the way over, Rushi's got this big target on their back. They're state champion runner-up. They're 10-1 coming in tonight. They've got all the momentum. They're number 3 in the state. Houston's got everything to play for, and Houston, this is really their type of the game. 48 points they've given up. Their trail 48-46. Something John Willoughby really wanted was a low-scoring game. Gives his Wildcats a chance to win this, and they're definitely in it with 43 seconds remaining.
And he's gotten the low-scoring ball game as well.
Richardson over to Grubbs. To Brock, three-pointer, top of the key, short, off the front of the rim, no good. It's going to be knocked out of bounds, look like off Brandewey, and it'll be Rushi ball with 29.9 seconds remaining, and the Raiders lead by 2. Cardonier in for the Raiders. as Derek Grubbs and Simons in for Houston.
Now here you try to get the steal off the inbounds and then foul as quick as you can.
It's exactly what happened. Borchers is able to get the ball and I think that's Collins. He was called for the foul, his second, and the team's ninth, so it's still a 1-1 for Rushi. The next foul by Houston will send the Raiders for 2 free throws.
Now, can't fault Houston's Adam Brock on that last shot. He had a wide open look for a 3.
Borcher's first attempt is good. It's his first trip to the charity stripe tonight. He's got 10 points. 3-point lead for Rushi. 27.5 seconds remain, and it connects on the next one. 4-point lead for Rushi. As time just ran off the clock, actually. As I looked up and clock time had ran off.
Oh, about 3 seconds. I think it was like 27.2 or 27.4 seconds. Now, as an official, you can either say count to 3 and then start the clock, or you put the 3 seconds back on.
Now the referee will call another one over.
And they can't come up and take a look at our stuff because we don't have instant replays. So.
And I think maybe that's what they'll do is they'll count to 3 because they're bringing the coaches together. But no, it looks like maybe they're going to try and add it back on.
Thank you.
And as they do, 27.5 seconds remain.
Actually, they gained, I think it was 27.4, if I'm not mistaken. But
50-46, Houston leads over the Raiders here in Houston. Fourth quarter, Shelby County League basketball. Johnson will bring it up for Houston. Don't really need a 3-pointer right here.
No, they if they get it, that's fine, but they're not even going to get that, and that's...
3 subs that came in last time, Cardonier, Grubbs, and Collins will check back in for the Raiders and Wildcats, respectively. That's a big turnover there by the Wildcats. Elsass gets it into Borchers, and he's going to be fouled by Grubbs. Rushi will shoot 2 free throws the rest of the 18.1 seconds remaining.
Yeah, it's got to be frustrating as for Houston as you have them right in your grasp. You're leading 46-44 and let it slip away.
Borchers connects on the first one. Johnson back in. Cardonier takes the seat for Rushi. Borchers misses a second one. Richardson with the rebounds. 15 seconds remain. Johnson kicks it in the corner. Shot is no good by Collins. Grubbs now with the ball. Kicks it up off the rim. No good. Tip in by Richardson. No good. Second one is no good, but we're going to have a foul. Look like on Rushi from the backside. It is on Rushi. It's going to be on...
Looks. It's not over by any stretch of the imagination. It's a 5-point ball game, 51-46.
Nathan Marshall was the culprit on the foul. It's his 5th foul. He'll check out with 1 point, the 6'5 senior.
But having said that, things have to go exactly Houston's way in the last 3.3 seconds. He has to hit both free throws, and they have to either come up with a steal right away and hit the 3-pointer, or foul immediately, hope that Rushi misses 1, and that's it.
He was shooting 2s in the act. Jordan Richardson was 1 of 2 coming in for that one. He misses that one. 5-point game still. Richardson connects on the second one. He's 2 of 4 on the evening. Now we're going to have a foul on Houston.
Now he made the free throw. The ball did not come in. It should be 3.3 seconds.
And its clock says 2.8.
And nobody's caught it.
Francis will go to the line. He misses the first one. Woody Francis, 2 of 5 so far from the charity stripe.
At least nobody from Houston has caught it.
And he makes the second one.
And that pretty much, it's sealed anyway.
52-47 remains. Johnson, three-pointer right side, around the rim, and no good. But Rushi walks out of Houston with a 52-47 lead here in the Shelby County League. Once again, 52-47, Rushi defeats the Houston Wildcats.
Helping bring you this event, the Made Right Sandwich Shop, located on North Broadway in Greenville, by the Ansonia Lumber Company on Main Street in Ansonia, Gilbert Feller's Funeral Home located in Brookville, Greenville National Bank with several locations in Dark County, by Cox Insurance located in Ansonia and Greenville, by Homestretch Sportswear located in St. Henry and Wapakoneta, and by M. Bixler Video Productions. Helping bring you this event, by Oliver Floyd Funeral Home in Greenville, Montage Cafe on Broadway in Greenville, by McCain Painting Incorporated, located in Greenville, by Osgood State Bank, located in Osgood, Family Health Services in Greenville, Arcanum, Versailles, and New Madison, by State Farm Insurance, your agent, Jim Gable, and by M. Bixler Video Productions.
And we're back here at Houston, a 52-47 win for the Rushi Raiders as they improved to 7-1 in the Shelby County Athletic League. And I'm not sure if it's 11-1 or 12-1 at this point, but nonetheless, just
12-1.
One loss. But yes, that'd be my guess too. But they come in here ranked third in the state, ranked third in the Dayton Daily News as well, and just a great all-around performance, although I'm sure Paul Primogen definitely will find some things that they can work on after tonight as well.
Yeah, exactly. You know, he's probably hoping to score a little more than 52 points tonight. As you know, it was a battle. They come out on fire in the first quarter, and second half or halftime they led by 7. And the third quarter, they seemed to get a little lackadaisical on defense, and let Houston really back into the game. And in the fourth quarter, Houston took the lead, and it just but it was something that definitely he'll need to take a look at on the tape. And you know, they go tomorrow night, another road game. They had 6 road games in a row, 7 out of the last 8, and so that's going to be a tough thing for his Raiders too.
And as of this taping, not an easy game tomorrow night as they travel to Minster.
Yeah, very tough game, MAC school up there. Minster's been playing very well of late. Mike Lee's got his kids playing very well up there, as he does every year, and he knows how to put some good players on the floor. And it's going to be a tough game for the Raiders traveling up to Minster in another almost atmosphere just like this one was here tonight at Houston.
One area that, you know, I said that Paul Brummagen probably can work on, and an area that they struggled with tonight was the pressure that Houston put on. They committed 14 turnovers. 14 turnovers, a lot of teams would probably be pretty satisfied with that, but Rushi, I'm sure they'd like to see it less than that.
Yeah, you want to see your players do a better job of handling the ball, and especially Kyle Gill, a 6-foot senior, really ran the point for Rushi, and you know, they seemed to turn over the ball a lot, but we saw a lot of turnovers on silly passes. Guy was a cutting and he wasn't looking for the ball, and that's something that, you know, they'll take a look at on Saturday morning, and they'll say, hey, this is what we need to do, keep our heads up a little more, and watch out where we're going to be throwing these ball, and that's going to have to continue all through the season.
Rushi, after dominating the first half rebounding wise, it was 23-11 at the half. Rushi, 13 of those were offensive rebounds. Houston came out second half a lot better job. In fact, 32-28, the final rebounding tally. Rushi out rebounding, or Houston out rebounding Rushi in the second half, 17-9. And if there's one thing that John Willoughby talked about at halftime, I'm sure it was, we've got to keep them off the offensive boards.
Exactly. Took a look at the stats and said, hey, these are not good in our instincts. We've got to get to the boards more often. And it's a team that really can do that with Richardson and Johnson. They've got some, and Brandwee, they've got some tall kids. They can go to the boards. And we've seen a lot of offensive rebounding there, especially in the fourth quarter by the Wildcats. And so he went in at halftime and obviously told them, we got to get to the boards. And it showed in the second half.
Well, we mentioned Rushi going to 7-1, keeping basically now in a virtual tie, depending on what Fort Laramie did tonight as well. But Fort Laramie was 6-0, Rushi was 6-1 heading into tonight's ball game. So Houston, on the other hand, was 4-3 and 6-6. They now fall to 500 in the SCAL at 4-4 and drop below 500 overall at 6-7. And things don't get easier for Houston as well.
No, they've got, Shelby County League, as we talked about, is very tough. And I forget who they have on Saturday night, but it's just a tough league to play in. You know, when you've got Jackson Center, they're always tough. You've got Rushi, you've got Anna, you got Fort Laramie. You
Botkins.
Play a lot of Botkins. Fairlawn is playing pretty well so far this year. There's a lot of tough schools in there, and Houston's got to be pretty happy with what, a loss, they're not going to be happy with that. But the fact that they held Rushi to 52 points tonight and almost walked out of here with a victory, they got to be very happy with that, to see some positives out of that. Just really the first half, almost, they almost shot themselves in the foot by not going to the boards and being down early in the first quarter.
Go ahead and run down the scoring here tonight.
Well, first for Rushi, as you mentioned, they improved to 11-1, maybe 12-1 overall, 7-1 in the Shelby County League. They were led by Jay Borchers. He had 12 points unofficially. Cody Francis with 11. Kyle Gill with 10. Lee Rosenbeck with 8. Danny Alsace with 7. Nathan Marshall with 1. And Luke Cardonier made a nice contribution off the bench with 5 points. The Houston Wildcats, they fall overall to 6-7 in the Shelby County League. They fall to 4-4. They were led by, actually, they had two players with 12 points. Jesse Johnson, the 5'11 senior, and Kyle Brandwee, the 6'4 senior. Once again, both those guys with 12 points. Brian Collins, 9 points. Nice contribution off the bench. Dustin Grubbs was 6. Adam Brock had 8. Jordan Richardson, 2, and Derek Grubbs with 1 point for the Houston Wildcats.
Houston had Rushi right where they wanted him, 46-44 late in the fourth quarter, but let it just, like sand through the hourglass, it just slipped through their fingers and end up falling by 5, 52-47.
That's something probably John Willoughby will take a look at and say, hey, we were up. We've really got to finish now this game, and go hard at it in the last 2 minutes. And they'll take a look at that, and that'll improve. And you'll see an improvement when it gets to February and closer to tournament time. They'll be able to finish off games, the Wildcats will.
At the time of this taping, girls' tournament drawings in most areas take place tomorrow. The boys will be taking place Saturday, Sunday, depending on where you're at. And of course, I never know with the Mercer County drawings when the tournament brackets take place, because last year I talked to Scott Brunswick after the drawings took place. Actually, it was about a week or two after the tournament brackets had been decided for the Dayton area, and they hadn't even drawn yet. They were drawing the next on that Sunday. So I never know when those drawings are taking place. So I need to find those things out.
Yeah, it might help a little bit, but either way, you see a lot of good teams come out of both those brackets. And as we were talking earlier, Houston doing in the 90s played very well in girls basketball and women girls basketball. A lot of Shelby County League teams come out in boys basketball. Fort Laramie, Rushi, Jackson Center was there a few years ago, also in girls basketball. So it's you're going to see a lot of these teams. And I think, if I had to make a prediction now, Fort Laramie and Rushi are the two men's teams, boys teams to watch, when it does come tournament time.
Well, and Houston, they're going to be a threat to somebody come tournament time as well. Any of these Shelby County League teams come tournament time, I wouldn't want to play them.
Well, they're what you call sleepers for sure. Shelby County League is a sleeper, really, because you never know which team will come. And if you bring that good team, you better watch out, because they'll pour it on you.
Once again, the final score here from Houston, Rushi pulling out the win, a 52-47 win over the Houston Wildcats. For our camera operator, Mike Sees, for Scott Ward, I'm Mark Bixler. Until next time, so long, everybody.